received falls are from the knitted fold of the blanket. It's a barter proceed from the seamstress's union dated 2 days ago. Right around the corner is reported time of day. Death. And customer someone. The server's name is this is Coyote. Okay, so now we got a clue. What's up everyone, it's Fastom and welcome back to another episode of Shadowrun Return. So last time we were going through the Barrens and we found out that it's a really weird, crazy place, tags all around, people going mad about spirits and stuff. So in this episode, trying to get a move on this investigation and seeing who the hell killed our friend somewhat. So we're gonna hop right into it and continue on our journey. Was that a mistake? Nah, want them to know who's the new guy in town, you know? Okay, we gain karma. Can we check that here? Oh yeah, we can. We can spend our karma. This Jake. Uh-huh. I'm thinking of upgrading strength. Use to calculate the chance to hit with melee and throwing weapons or the elements of fire grenade you can throw. I'm thinking of getting like spirit summoning. Maybe decking and range combat. Yeah. Yep. Okay, we're much better now. Who are you? Just need a fix. Bobby. What's up, Bob? Oh, Stream Stresses Union. That's where it is. Hey, Chamber, got some tasty morsels for you. Just what every well-dressed Sergeant Runner should have in his back pocket. Let me see what you have. Oh, so this is where by consumables. Kamikaze. From a team that increases body plus 2 strength and willpower for 5 rounds. Only 5 rounds? Natural, for 5 rounds you can get strength, willpower, charisma and intelligence. Alright. Who's this guy? This is the best place, sick to party. Alright. Seamstress, can I get in there? The sound of laughter and music emanates from within, but you should finish your investigation first. Okay, let's talk to this guy, Dan the Donut Man. The smell of fried food, powdered sugar, and slightly burnt soy cuff is almost enough to overpower the dusky sewage stain of Rainbow Streets. The troll walking the stand is covered in food stains older than he is. What can I get you, Shummer? Before I talk to him, I'll take a jelly donut and a soy cuff. Got the money from thing, you know, the crest stick from the dude somewhat. His body. Enjoy. Did you see the Mara in the alley across the way? Nope, I was close when it happened. But hey, it's the Barrens. The back alley killing enough is new around here. The only reason the cops are making a big deal about this rip of business is that some of the victims are real people. You know, folks with sins. So, what are sins? They only consider real people. People with sins? What can you tell me about the Barrens? The Barrens? Hell, if you have to ask, you probably shouldn't be out here. This sanctuary we're on is called Taurus Fildo. And I suppose it's the closest thing around here to respectable. If you're migrants, and you might even survive drinking the water if you're lucky. Wouldn't recommend it though. Scratches his armpit. Now behind me, that's the seamstress's union. You want drinks, strikes, favors, or information around here? Your union's your spot. Hell, that place is the reason I'm in business. Folks get the munchies when they party. Mrs. Kubota owns the joint, and she's quality. A hard woman, but fair. I'll see you around. Who's that? Sally. The dwarf mentioned is packing up her stand for the night. Oh, I'm close. Come back tomorrow. Never mind. I'll be going. Got a great view of that alley across the street. Don't suppose you saw the matter that happened there? She grunts. Sure. I was closing up when I hear a series of explosions from behind the union. A couple seconds later, this guy comes out running across the street. Didn't get a good look at him. Then all the lights in the alley exploded all of a sudden. Things got pretty quiet after that. Let me guess, you didn't go running over to see if that guy was okay. Hell no, around here that kind of thing gets you killed. Thank you for your time. No problem. Useless. There, I think that's the crime scene. Okay. Okay, as you approach the scene of Sam's murder, Jake spies the flashing red and blue lights up ahead. Whoa, hold up a minute. Lone Star is at the pub collecting on a cop issued bounty. And the one on my head isn't going away anytime soon, he sighs. Sorry, friend. I think this is where I pass the verge. Thanks again for the help with those Halloween ears. Here's your payment. 1,000. Okay. They don't take too long where I'm going, and you look like you could use the funds. Good luck out there. Likewise, Jake, give me a call when you're in the clear. Yeah, sure. He starts to leave, then tilts his head back. Hey, one more thing. When you're done checking out your pal's crime scene, pop into the seamstress's unit. It's just down the street. You need gear information, or just a damn stiff drink, that's the place to be. Best dive this side of Chicago. I used that place as a base of operation for years back in the day. Make the right friends there, and I'm sure you'll get to the bottom of this Reaper's business. Well, nice knowing you. Jake turns and disappears in the shadow depths of the Redmond Barrens. Gear, huh? Okay. So apparently they have gear out there. Let's get in there. William. The bright yellow police tape cuts through the dark blue tattoo's path, directing your eyes to the white chalk outline and the dark red stain marking the slab of pavement where someone's died. Standing at the entrance to the alley is a Lone Star officer. The cop looks cold, angry, and irritated at the homeless man who is currently pestering him. So, Lone Star, that's the name of the police. I keep telling you, I need to get myself from the alley and I'm gonna die in the cold tonight. And I've been trying to explain to you that this is an official Lone Star investigation. I can't tell any, let anyone in here. Hey, I got my rights. Look, you sinless garbage, I've got a job to do. Find a new blanket or find a reason to use my stun baton. Typical, I hate you pigs. Damn. Shouldn't police officers be more nice? Looks in your direction. Now what? You know what? Long night, eh? You look cold, so I picked up a donut and some cold swag after you. Just take that. Hey, thanks. The officer's face lights up as he takes a sip. He seems pretty trusting for an officer of the law. You know, when my dad was a cop, this was back when cops actually worked for the government. So now they don't. Just a lot of bribes, huh? He said folks would buy him coffee all the time, but I hadn't seen it till now. So what can I do for you? I'm actually working for the dead man and help finding his killer. Can I come into the alley and look around a bit? Your client is in chalk line? That's messed up, man, but I respect it. Okay, but don't mess anything up now that anyone would likely notice, because the forensics aren't coming back. Okay. So he just needed some soy calf and that's it. I missed the shards of glass from the broken lights. You find a small piece of glass which looks like the bottom of a test tube. Okay. Escape crime scene. These two are distinct sets of footprints. A human ending at the chalk outline and the larger set possibly orc or troll falling just behind the first. Orc or troll. So it was kind of a orc or troll that killed him. Alright. Their work like this new, you can see that all the alley's normal lights have been ruined. Up a close inspection, seems that they all been imploded, as if some force shattered them all at the same time. Probably hacking, eh? Could it be magic? I'm feeling hacking. This looks like the coat and blanket that the old man was trying to get back. Picard examined there for evidence. Bar tab received. As you shuffle the bundle of cloth to the side, a printed receipt falls out from beneath the fold of the blanket. It's a bar tab receipt from the seamstress's union dated 2 days ago at 2 a.m. Right around the corner is reported time of day. Death. The customer someone. The server's name is this is Coyote. Okay, so now we got a clue. Gotta find this Coyote. Pick up the coat and blankets. Let's just give the guy his blanket. And you got 3 karma for that, okay. William. The streets have not been kind to this man, but they also harden him. This man is clearly a survivor, though one wrestling with the onset of age and arthritis. You, I saw you over there with that rat bastard coat. What you want? I think this coat and his blankets belong to you. Give him the coat. Yeah. That probably warm him up for us. My staff, my decent of you, don't see that kind of thing often out here. Know anything about the murder that took place here? squints at you suspicions. You a copper? Working for some cop? Just a freelancer. I need to ask some questions. No, I'm as sinless as you. Mind answering a few questions? Hey, what makes you think I'm sinless? Just messing with you. Of course I'm sinless. This is my day number, my ass. What kind of questions you got? You see the murder? Nope, and I can't say I'm sorry I missed it. I was holding crates for Mr. James up the market. Can't carry as many as I used to, so it took a while. Got back here in time to see a couple tourists poking all over my home turf. But then that jerk face in the uniform had already set up shop in my alley. So it sounds like you live in this alley? Sure, for the last couple of months I've been sleeping there. But I spend my days out doing odd jobs for the street merchants or panhandling tourists over the near seamstress's union. What else did you see that night? Well, you know, earlier that night I saw a big and ugly troll in the greenhouse blue scrub snooping around the block. He brought some donuts and two cups of soy cups over there. Seemed nervous, but he did everything with his left hand because his right was all screwed up with some cyberware. Okay. Can you tell me more about the troll cyberware? Well, it was big and I think it must have had some hospital attachments because I saw some needles. It was a lot like one I saw back in 44 when I got captured by elves. They did all sorts of experiments on me. Let me tell you, never trust one of them cyber people. So I needed to know. Thanks. See you around. More clues. Interesting. So now, seamstress's union. Let's talk to this guy first. Okay. Take another gel and swag, I've never known who else might need it. Sell some donuts to a troll wearing scrubs last night? Maybe. What's it to you? I sell a lot of donuts to a lot of people. I know Lone Star Profiles meta humans. I tell them about a troll that brought donuts from me right before murder. They haul him in just to see if anyone will pay the bill. Not today, my friend. I'll see you around. Damn, alright. Seamstresses. Let's get in. You're about to leave the Burns and enter Seamstress's unit. Will you like to proceed? Yes. Should probably have... okay. Did my karma. I have like 3 extra more. Relative to the rest of the Burns, Storysville is a neon-clothed oasis. At its set is a Seamstress's unit, housed in an old brownstone building on the corner of Illegal and Opportunity. Bums huddle together. Gangsters strut the streets and the occasional salaryman comes slumming. The union building has been retrofitted, rebuilt and restocked so many times that it's like an aging Scarlet wearing too much makeup in an attempt to stay young. The wildlife growing out of the gutters adds to this effect. As you enter, the murmur of harsh conversation washes over you. The dive bar denizens raise their heads. Take your measure and then go back to business. This is the kind of place where everyone knows your name but keeps to themselves. Seems like a cool place then. 2 extra karma? So they just keep on giving me karma like that? And spend it. I noticed I need a strength to like intimidate that officer, so I'm probably gonna put on that. Create a little bit of close combat. Can be manhandled by these guys, you know. So this is the seamstresses. Okay. Cherry bomb. Okay. The bartender is striking off sporting a perfectly toned body, perfectly pouty lips, and perfectly tapered ears. Her eyes harmonize, save me, and take me in equal measure, hitting just right notes for the maximum extraction of tips. Hey there, I haven't seen you here before, what can I get you? Something dead in a clean glass. About a date? From the looks of this place, I can probably get anything I want. She eyes you up and down. I just sling booze, but the union is known for its diverse clientele. Ask around, you'll probably find someone who can get you what you're looking for. Now, how about a drink? Soika, black and hot. She starts to turn away when a man with a face of a survival and the zeal of a convert tags at her heart. It's clear the two have a history. They try to keep the voices low, but the intensity of the conversation makes them easy to overhear. Cherry, you have to listen to me. If you stick around here, you could end up dead. Of course, the Reaper is out there and it's real. The last killing happened just down this block, and now Coyote's missing. You'll probably find her tomorrow in a dumpster. Without a head, come on, cherry bomb thing. I think plenty, Shane. I'm getting a PH freaking D from UW in neuroprosthetics, studying under Ochman's. I know I'm not paying for it, bartending tips. There are faster ways for a Baron's girl to earn that kind of scratch, but I'm not taking them. So, what you want from me? I want what you want, a better life, a better world for everyone. The universal brother you can give you that. I've had this before. This isn't some trick to get us back together. Things are different now. I'm different now. The brotherhood. Cherry Bomb's pretty face is sad, armored in lipstick and low expectations. The universal brotherhood is for other people, Shane. Rich, Bellevue types who can afford the membership fees and voluntary donations. This isn't about money, it's about binding the world together in brotherhood. Come with me, attend a discovery meeting, get to the core of who you are. I had Lynn Telestrian give a talk last night called The New Family of the Sixth World. I've got a family right here, Shane. The drunks and lowlifes and whores, and I've chosen them over any of your brotherhood members. Now, Buzz, I need to get back to work. With a body language that leaves no question that the conversation is over, Cherry Bomb turns her back on him. Damn, sorry I got interrupted. I heard he's got the strength of the righteous, doesn't he? Boyfriend find relation? Pretty high, is narrow, something like that. You've got a look that says you're not just here for the entertainment. Your badge, do I look like a cop? That is a highlight. No, baby, you look like someone who knows the shadows. We're trained to spot a bronze the minute they walk in. Something I can help you with? I have a few questions. Ask away. Tell me about this place. Some come here for booze, some for companionship, others are looking for something they can't get anywhere else. If it's legal or immoral and it can be brought, sold, rented or consumed, you can probably find it here. The union seems to attract people like you. Who was that you were talking to? Shane Hoboffer. He used to work here. One day he saw a billboard for the Universal Brotherhood, and that was that. Went to a meeting, made new friends, moved in with them. I was happy for him until he started coming around trying to recruit me. I knew in that dark. That guy mentioned Coyote. She's here? She looks worried. No, I think she's away on business. Business, huh? Is this Shaman with a name like Coyote? No, she shot a coyote once, thinking it was a shaman who double-crossed her. We've been calling her Coyote ever since. Face falls. She's been missing for a couple of days now. Some people think the Reaper got her, but I know her. Coyote can take care of herself. Ever hear the name Sam Watts? Sam was a regular customer and a regular pain in the ass for as long as I've been here. Talked a big game, but he was always broke. As soon as he caught any money in his pocket, it went straight to his head. Chips, drugs, or booze. Coyote had a soft spot for him, though. Did you see Sam on the night he died? No, that was Coyote's ship. Who runs this place? I want to talk to them. That'd be Miss Kubota. She's in the back room. You can't miss her. Thanks for the intel. I appreciate the help. Got a punk, so I have to stick together. Talk to you later. Okay. Does dude have swords in his bag? That's not how Coyote does it. Eric Merciman. Hey guy, I've got some extra outfits I'm trying to unload. You want first tips? I'll take a look. Oh, so this is where you get the armor. Dress one step above street ganger, grants HP plus 3. But that's expensive. Damn. Okay, I have the secure samurai clothing. Okay. A lot of this stuff is expensive. I don't have the money for that just yet. Sweeten the deal. Oh, don't rip, don't marry it. What? Jean Parks, the Asian woman expression reads open for business, but her demeanor reads dealer rather than companion. She has a jack on her neck, a gun on her hip, and a chip on her shoulder. She eyes you with a sneer. You look like you could use some firepower, something simple. I've got guns so smart they practically fire themselves. You're looking for tech? Got some of that too. If that's the way you roll, show me what you got. So these are the guns. Machete, damage 4. Baseball bat. And the drones. Grenades. Okay. I'm thinking machete. Yeah. Let's get that. Yep. Equipped. Confirm. So this is where I go to get guns. I like that. Let's go talk to Mr. Clue. Posted at the doorway of the VIP section is a tower of troll muscle wrapped in an impossibly tailored suit, whether the product of good jeans or expensive aftermarket cosmetic work. The troll's gleaming horns perfectly frame his face. And his polished tacks and goatee a cinch weight, the set of a Latin jaw. Welcome. Behave yourself. Will do. You get trouble in here often? Nothing a sin look can usually solve. You have business here looking into the death of someone. Heard about that. Real shame. What happened to him? There is a sharpness in Clue's eyes, the look of a man who has seen much and earned wisdom at a young age. I figure Sam was the type who needed to be thrown out on occasion. Encouraged to call it night, I'd say. Sam was a drunk, but he usually wasn't a violent one. Usually? What about the night he died? He was a bit agitated, didn't catch the specifics, might have been of a woman. Though I was going to have to show him out, but I had to deal with a couple of rival war gangers posturing for the one. For one of the working girl upstairs, Jake helped Sam out instead. Thanks for the info. No problem. Alright. Johnny Clean? What? Johnny Clean. Alright. The man is dressed like a janitor, but he's wearing unusually clean overalls. He's so real thin and has a cunning look in his eyes that says he's more than just a maintenance man. Howdy, name's Johnny Clean. You new? Yeah, first time, just getting a look at the place. Well, enjoy yourself. This looks like your type of place. I'm just sweeping up a bit. They probably asked a few questions. Man, that was a bad decision. Alright. Nog. Who's this guy? Covered in glowing magical talisman and fetishes, the troll does not seem fully of this world. He mumbles to himself constantly, apparently participating in several conversations at once, but with his entities you can neither see nor hear. Told you, it's not like that at all. Bring me proof and you shall have it. I am honored, your majesty. But that was why I said to use mustard instead of ketchup. But forgive me, Jin, I was a fool. He looks you in the eyes at the conversations on hold. You may peruse my magical words and see the glory. I would like to view your words. Damn, so this is where we get the magic stuff. Consumables, chi casting, spells, weapons. So power bolt is considered as a weapon? What? I don't know why. Okay, I'm thinking of buying. I'm gonna get power bolt. Yeah, I want a few spells, you know. Heal wound, spell casting, 2 mana bolt. We got armor. Wait, what? Can I not move? Okay, that's a spell. Conjuring. Haste. Increase the spell target speed for 2 rounds. Slow. Chi casting. Just buffs and buffs and consumables. So this is where we summon the spirits, okay? Gotta get a bit of power bolt. Wait. or powerbolt is considered as a weapon. Wait, what? But there's a place for spells. Oh, I'm guessing that's flamethrower and mana bolt. Okay, let's get the flamethrower then. Yeah, right there. Confirm. How much? Awesome. No gigs at the moment. So you're a Shadowrun as well? So this is Mrs. Kubota. Mrs. Kubota watches you across the room, sizing you up as you approach. As you get closer, you can see that she's a mixed race, African and Japanese. Her demeanor says, "This is my house. Mess with it at your peril." But her eyes twinkle with a playful light when she speaks. Konbanwa, good evening. Konbanwa, good evening. Are you enjoying the seamstress's union? There should be plenty for a man like you to enjoy. She eyes you closely. Or is this business? I'm tempted to ask what's upstairs, but not tempted enough? She laughs. Tell me, oh my, what is it you're looking for? I'm looking for information. Of course you are. Knowledge is power, eh? So I've been told. So okay, why should I tell you? Somewhat, I'm looking for a skiller. Face brightens, amused. So you are the little insurance policy would go on about when he was drunk. He's an avenging angel who would strike back for him from beyond the grave. What you want to know? How well did you know, son? I knew him. We all did. Sam was a regular here. Whenever he could beg or borrow enough yuan to become altered in some way, tried chips, alcohol, it didn't matter to Sam. As long as he was bent, he was always looking for his next fix. He clung to this place like it was his lifeline, and we treated him as part of the family, even if none of us truly liked him, except Coyote. Did you see Sam on the night of his death? He was here, quite inebriated, as he often was. Coyote was working bar that night, and she informed me that Sam was getting rowdy and belligerent with other customers. When I requested delivery, he refused. My bouncer, Mr. Clue, was off dealing with another issue, so I requested that Jake escort Sam out the back door to the alley. That was the last I saw either of them. Why is this place called the Shrimp Stresses Union? During the gold rush here, there was a census, and the politicians wanted a high number of possible to gain power and revenue. To bolster those numbers, they decided to include all the working girls, of which there were many, to the roles. However, given the times, they could not list the girls through occupation, so they entered them as all as seamstresses. When a girl accumulated enough money to open her own place of business, she named it the Seamstresses Union, so potentially workers would know that they would be treated fairly there, and thus a rich tradition was born. So you're former seamstresses? No, perhaps when we know each other more, I will reveal more about myself. For now, enjoy the union. One more question. Can you tell me where to find Coyote? Face darkness. Oh, that I could. I have not seen in 2 days. She is a smart woman and quite dangerous, but I fear for her. If she is that dangerous, why fear for her? Yes, if you are what they think you are, you know there is always someone more dangerous. Her room is upstairs. If you're looking for her, I invite you to examine it. You may be able to uncover her whereabouts. I would not normally betray her privacy in this way, but she's missed 2 shifts now and cannot be reached on her comb. It is unlike her. If something has happened, I will not have inaction on my conscience. Here's the key. Alright. So we're about to go upstairs.